In this video, I'm going to share with you my favorite defense for defending 2x2 compression-based sets in Madden 22. Now, if you're new to the channel, hit that subscribe button below. It's completely free to subscribe to the channel, and it just allows you to be able to stay up to date with the latest tips and strategies that we share every single day right here on the YouTube channel. Now, like I said, we're going to be talking in this video about how you stop or how you can contain 2x2 compression-based sets. Now, I think these are actually relatively effective in this year's game. I think there's a lot of good route combos that can be had from 2x2 compression. There's no better route combo, in my personal opinion, than the bench concept or like a wide receiver cross type concept. And so we're going to share with you in this video how you can kind of, put yourself in a pretty decent position, in my opinion, to defend this 2x2 compression. Now, 2x2 compression, like I said, is one of the more difficult offenses to defend, but we're going to be using 2-4-5 odd. Now, I love the 2-4-5 odd. I think it's probably the best defense in the game this year. Especially against the pass. The pressure that you can create from this formation is absolutely incredible. And so the beauty of this formation is that we can flip it relatively easily. The beauty of the coverage we're going to call is we can tweak it depending on what formation we're running, and we're actually going to be able to create essentially cover four quarters out of this formation. So let's jump into the video. 2-4-5 odd, cover six. And if you want to get my full 2-4-5 odd ebook, there's a link in the description. I'll show you how to run the entire defense. Now, all we're going to do, this is actually relatively simple. We're going to flip our play so that this blitzing linebacker, Simmons, is opposite of the running back. So if the running back's on the right, then we'll flip the play typically. If we don't have to, we don't have to. But we just want to make sure that the linebacker is opposite side of the running back, which is going to significantly help our chances of being able to get consistent pressure against this formation. So we're going to flip the play here, and this is what you're going to see. Now, what I like to do out of this is I like to go ahead and spread my defensive line because the alignment can sometimes be a little weird against these type of sets. This is also going to put us in a pretty good position to stop the run because we can just shoot this gap. If they run inside zone, we'll stand kind of right over here and try to shoot down into the gap, or we could even hover right over the center or whatever you want to do. So we're going to be using on the three rec hook defender. Now, from a setup perspective, it's actually relatively simple. All we're going to do is we are going to crash our defensive line to the right. That's going to set up our pressure. And then we're going to create, like I said, a cover four quarters look. So we're going to put the outside cornerback on the left side into an outside quarter zone. We're going to put the defensive linebacker that's in the middle of the field into a curl flat coverage, as you can see right there. And then you can put this guy in man coverage on the running back if you want to. It will help some of those seam wheel reads and things like that. You don't have to, but you certainly can. Or you can put him in a three rec hook or a bluff blitz assignment, which will turn him into a three rec hook. But basically what you want to think about here in this defense is your responsibility. And then we're going to inside quarter. I apologize. We're going to inside quarter this guy over here on the left. And so your responsibility on this defense is three rec hook, which means you're going to open up to the three wide receiver side. In this case, it's the running back side. So let me show you real quick. This is also why I will occasionally, and most of the time, do like to man this guy up on the running back just to kind of help some of the running back routes, because you want to have freedom. If you see a receiver, so you're opening up to this three receiver side, and if you see either one of those two receivers running a crossing route, that is your responsibility. You need to go get that. If you don't, then just work to the running back or any backside drags coming across, okay? So that's kind of how I like to defend this. And anyways, we'll just show you first and foremost the bench concept, which, like I said, is probably the best concept from this. Snap the ball. You're going to open up. Nothing crosser. Okay, we're going to sit right down. And as you see, we're able to play pretty good defense against this package. Now, the other beauty of the cover six is that the deep half in the cover six is a match coverage deep half. What that means is, let's say, for example, they run that concept again, we leave the deep half, you'll see that deep half will actually kind of match to the player. He didn't really go to get it, but he will occasionally do that. Now, another thing that you could do, like I said, against this is we're going to flip the play. I like to show blitz, and what it does is it brings these quarter zones down into a really favorable position for them to be able to make a play. So something like this, as you can see, and again, we're just setting up that same coverage, but now we've got this quarter zone in a decent position to make the play. You open up three wide receiver side. Now, Kirk is just roasting him. That's more of a play recognition problem, but as you can see, we're putting ourselves in a decent position to be able to stop this, okay? So now another thing that you could do from this is if you wanted to leave the cover six, you could leave this cover six. The one thing that I would advise is if you're going to leave the cover six, What you want to do with this linebacker is you want to, instead of using the three-rec hook defender, now you want to use this vertical hook, because in the situation like bench, you're climbing vertical, you see that, you can go help on that if you want, put yourself in a decent position to be able to make a play. On the front side of the formation, the quarters or the cover four side of the cover six, you're going to find that we're in a pretty good position for the most part. So let me show you the bench concept from the right now. And if you take a look at this, the corner route is not going to get open, as you can see, very, very much so taken away. And that's primarily because we have a quarter flat zone on that side. So that's why I'm saying, if you want to kind of help out a little bit, you could use her, you could call your cover six, and then you could just use her right here, because that soft squat will play more like a quarter flat. You could even take that guy in the middle and put him in an inside quarter, so he's going to match a crosser. And then what that's going to allow you to do is it's going to allow you to come back in here and be able to take this away, kind of help on that is what I'm getting at. So that's the beauty of this quarters coverage. There's a lot of things that you can adapt to it from. Now I want to show you another adjustment here. So this is if they run the mesh. This is something that I think is really popular, especially out of the Carolina gun tight. All they're going to do is they're going to basically run like a flat zone, and then they're going to run like a drag or something, right? And they're going to open up space to be able to throw this wheel. So if you look at this right here, the beauty of the quarter is that outside the outside quarter will take that wheel route. So all you have to do is open up to the side, delay it for a second, and then be able to work to a crosser, okay? And that's one of the big things that I like about this. So, you know, you're really looking primarily in this defense, you're the one that's looking for any crossing route type of stuff that could be coming. That's really your primary responsibility. So if they run the play mesh, and let's say that even they put the flat over there, now you're coming here, and you see we've got pretty good match defense on that wheel route because of that outside quarter zone. Whereas if you're just playing a standard cover three, they're going to pepper that wheel all game long if you don't do something about it. So that's why I like that. Also, you have to remember, we're sending really good pressure. This pressure off the left side is about 80 to 90% of the time going to come in completely untouched. So that's something that you have to remember as well whenever you're defending this formation. You're sending really good pressure. You can drop this guy on the right side, like I said, into a bluff blitz if you want to, and then you can play your quarters assignment. And then let's say they do something like a streak, and the corner, you know, this is a pretty good little package right here to stop this play. Obviously, that's more of what I'm saying, where you're going to have to kind of maybe work a little bit to that side. But for the most part, I really like how this defense defends gun tight. Now, the other thing that you have to understand is crossing routes and responsibilities. So this is where this defense, honestly, this year is a lot better than it was last year. They won't get as lost in the crossing action. So, for example, I'm just going to go to PA flood shot here. And what you're going to see on this is this crosser from right to left. You see he stays with it pretty well. And so that's where I'm talking about. You're looking for your primary option, your job is to look at which crosser is getting open consistently and to take that, whether it be on the right or the left. Most of the time it's going to be from left to right. I found that if they run something like this, and if they flip their back, I would flip your play too, but you don't have to. But again, you're going to see here that crosser gets matched by that inside quarter. So I just wanted to show that. So you're going to have pretty decent matching principles. One other little advanced tip that you can run against gun tight. Now, I will say this is something that, like I said, it's very, very advanced. It's something that you want to use situationally, but it's really good for those corner routes. All we're going to do is we're going to baseline and press. And then I like to go ahead and pinch my linebackers so that I have better leverage against the run. But then what we're going to do is we're going to put this outside corner on the left side into an outside third zone. And then we're going to put that inside quarter on the other side, just like that right there. So we have an outside third on the left. The reason this is really good is because baseline press thirds, they will do a decent job against these corner routes. As you see right there, he goes right to it, and he's able to take away the corner route. So they may think, oh, it's quarters, but no, it's not. You've got this adjustment. Now, the other reason why this is really good, and I don't have a great crossing route from this formation, but the other reason why this adjustment is really situational, but it's honestly really effective, is for a situation like this where they're running a lot of crossing routes. And what you're going to see here is if I get time in the pocket here, that crossing route to X, that outside third will oftentimes be able to take that away. So that's just something else that you want to kind of keep in your back pocket for the right situation at the right time. You can baseline and press this outside third on the left, or you can hot run them to an outside third. And then let's say that they run, this PA flood shot play, and, you know, they're running crosser, and then maybe they're running like, you know, some kind of pull route or something on the backside of this. And just for sake of demonstration, I'm going to block, I'm going to spy the defense because I want you to see what this does to a crossing route. But anyways, the snap of the ball, what you're going to see is this crosser, that outside third is not going to, if there's no vertical pull route, he's going to kind of sit in that area. And obviously, that's a short crosser, a deeper crosser he's going to have even better leverage on. So this is the best defense, in my opinion, right now for gun tight. Gun tight is a really tough offense to stop. There's a lot of things that people can do from gun tight this year, especially out of the Carolina book. So I think tight slots is one of the better offenses in the game right now. But this is something you can run that will help kind of slow it down a little bit and maybe get you some stops against that defense or that offense. So if you want to get the rest of the defensive ebook, this is just one play. We have a ton of setups in our defensive guide, from coverage perspectives to run defenses to absolute insane pressures that you can run at your opponent. So if you want to get access to that, all of that material is available by clicking the link in the description of this video. I put a link to the guide in the description. So you click that link, it'll take you right over to my website where you can get the full defensive ebook for just $15. Thanks for your time. I hope you enjoyed the video, and we'll see you guys in the next one.